You see the title. The previous reporters spoke about different threats. I also will speak about microbiological contamination, but we offer some possibilities of fighting with contamination. You see the motto, life is like riding a bicycle. To keep your balance, you must keep moving. Different senses of this expression of Albert Einstein. Of course, moving we understand not only mechanical moving, but progressive growth of free energy accumulated. Later on, we'll speak about free energy. And also it is about our immune system, which must move, should permanently be mobilized and react on the threats. You see the picture, which is actual state of coronavirus propagation in the world. And we should mention that microbiological decontamination is a challenging problem for Homo urbanus civilization. Many factors indicate the evident exacerbation of this problem. Continuous population growth combined with the increasing degree of its urbanization and mobility, intensification of the anthropogenic pressure upon the environment, amplified by periodical natural disasters and different scale technological catastrophes. Also, eventual biological terrorism threats should be taken into account. We can mention that COVID-19 is not the first contamination and probably is not the ultimate challenge. The fighting lasts, according to epidemiological criteria, transformation of a separate focus into a terrifying pandemic was facilitated, in our opinion, not only by underestimation of the virulence of the fresh coronavirus, but also the interpretation of this coronavirus infection mainly as a disease of dirty hands or the result of direct contact. Do you hear me?
Yes, yes.
Okay. I am disturbed because of because I cannot show the presentation in a traditional mode. Accordingly, the main tools for preventing the spread of infection are personal hygiene, avoiding direct contact, and wearing a mask, as well as spraying liquid disinfectants. We consider that that is not sufficient. It could be sufficient for the first stage of infection propagation, when preventive measures, large-scale testing in risk groups, adequate quarantine measures, vaccination, and so on, also timely identification of foci of infection at early stages, which enables doctors and other government agencies to track individual infections and eliminate the chain of infection. coronavirus infection rate in this case is smaller than 1. It means that there is a sufficient control under the propagation of infection, this first point. But it happens frequently that high levels of infection exceed the ability of the medical system to control the epidemic, and the epidemic is growing, and coronavirus infection rate is larger than 1. From above comes important conclusion. Epidemiological situation cannot be controlled without efficient in optimal way decontamination of air and surface. So not only hygiene, not only the control of dirty hands, but we should have an optimal, efficient control of decontamination of air and surface. So it is the subject of our presentation. One example which happened recently, a flight from one country which was suspended several times by Chinese aviation regulator for carrying COVID-19 patient was identified as a source of a latest outbreak. Airport cleaning staff were infected while cleaning the airplane's cabin. You see that this cleaning was several hours after the aircraft arriving in the airport, and no contact could be without passengers. But infection took place. So the decontamination of air and surfaces is very important. One work of from Norway, from Oslo, which confirms, in fact, that decontamination of air and surfaces is a challenge. The authors investigated the influence of precipitations on coronavirus propagation, and they found that precipitation are strangers for COVID, but the sun and warm temperatures are soulmates for COVID-19. It's an important conclusion. We confirmed this conclusion with observation of the situation for Republic of Moldova in period April, May of this year. What happened? At the beginning of April, we had more than 2,000 infections per day. And after 2 months, it was about 100 infections. So it means that something happened. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me?
Yes, but Mr. Boshnyaga, I would like to remember to you that you have 45 slides. Please concentrate on the main results because the time passed very quickly. And yes. You have only 15 minutes for presentation with questions together.
Okay. So this happened because we have the precipitations, the rains, which have a drizzling character, and they contributed to the purification of air from the dispersed contaminants. If you are not sure that rains contribute to the decontamination of air, you can see the statistics of more than 1 billion from India. This period corresponds to the rains, and you can see how was reduced the daily case. So you are convinced probably that we shall have the instrument for decontamination of air and surfaces. Antibiotics are not the solution. I pass to another slide. And pass to the optimization of the thermodynamic approach for sterilization problem. It is important to optimize because of the importance, and such measures should be sufficiently economically funded. Traditional methods do not ensure protection from coronavirus propagation. We propose thermodynamic methods for optimization of decontamination process. All organisms need permanent supply of free energy. This is a condition of life. And if we reduce the free energy, it means that we kill the organism. So this reduction is the goal of our method, to reduce the free energy of the formation. I don't speak about organism only, because viruses are non-cellular formation. I follow your opinion that I should be faster. The conclusion is that we shall reduce the free energy of the formation. How we can reduce? We can reduce by chemical spontaneous exothermic irreversible reactions of oxidation. So oxidation is the possibility to obtain the best solution, the optimal solution for decontamination. What should be the oxidant? Oxygen is the most indicated oxidizer. You can see it from this table. Of course, fluorine is more strong oxidizer, but it is not possible to use fluorine because of the ecological problem. So oxygen atoms should be used for oxidizing. We consider that cold non-equilibrium plasma chemical reaction of oxidation in oxygen atmosphere is the best and energy efficient method for irreversible sterilization. How can we obtain such a plasma? I will pass through the discussion of the ultraviolet. Ultraviolet is not the optimal solution for this problem. Japanese investigation of the macro of the bacteria placed on the exterior surface of the International Space Station, dry bacteria, survived 3 years. 3 years ultraviolet, inclusively extreme range of ultraviolet. So ultraviolet is not a solution. The solution is oxidation by atomic oxygen. How to obtain this oxygen? It is obtained in the best method is microwave plasma. So microwaves are the best method to generate cold non-equilibrium plasma, which generates atomic oxygen and consequently ozone, which is a result of here you see the explanation why microwaves are useful.
Please because present your conclusion, Mr. Bošnjaga, please, because time is past.
The time passed. Okay, so you see that microwaves ensure non-equilibrium plasma. The gas temperature is low, and electrons, which cause ionization and respectively the dissociation of the oxygen and other components is important. Here you see the oxygen plasma, how it is looking. I omit another possibility of use of high voltage. And also, I omit the use of radionuclides, which are used for maintaining of non-self-sustaining discharge in microwave oven. And the conclusions. Nowadays, non-thermal cold oxygen plasma could be considered functional energetically and ecologically as the most efficient tool for pathogenic microflora inactivation. Cold plasma provides energy efficient generation of oxidative reactive forms, atomic oxygen, ozone, hydroxyl radical, hydrogen peroxide, superoxide, and singlet oxygen. For remote objects, ozone generated and cold generated plasma ensures efficient decontamination. So, the solution for decontamination of air and surfaces is the generation of ozone in microwave plasma, oxygen plasma. This is our solution for to fight against the coronavirus. Unfortunately, we have time for implementation of this method, but we proved that it is the optimum. Questions, please.
Thank you. Any questions?
May I ask a question? Maybe I missed some points while presentation, but I want to ask you, what is the range of temperature of the cold, so-called cold plasma?
It is very different. Of course, it is incomparably smaller than plasma, which we call plasma. It is called plasma. We can vary this temperature from room temperature up to 300 degrees. This is the range. This is the range. But you can cool the oxygen which you ionize. Previously, if you cool, you can obtain smaller temperature. Up to cryogenic oxygen. So the temperature can be what you want to have.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much to all participants for presentation for interesting questions.